Hello friends, I am Professor S. R. Kale from KKWA College of Food Technology. Today I am here with another video of microbiology, that is history and scope of microbiology. We will begin with the introduction of microbiology. What is microbiology? Microbiology is simply defined as the study of living organisms which are invisible to naked eyes, or we can use microscope to study the microorganism. The study of microbiology subject is basically depend upon viruses, bacteria, algae, fungi and protozoa. Microorganisms are necessary for the production of bread, cheese, beer, antibiotics, vaccines, vitamins, enzymes, etc. Microorganisms. Now we will see what is microorganism. Microorganisms are smaller living things which we can see only under microscope. Microorganisms are everywhere. Almost every natural surface is colonized by microbes, from body to ocean. Some microorganisms can live hot spring and other in frozen sea ice also. Most of the microorganisms are harmless and some are harmful to human beings. Discovery of microorganism. Anthony van Leeuwenhoek in 1632 to 1723, who invented the first microscope with range magnification range of 50 to 300, was the first to accurately observe and describe the microscope. Spontaneous generation conflict. It is also called as spontaneous generation theory. From earliest time, people believe that living organism could develop from non-living or decomposing matter. The spontaneous generation theory was challenged by Reddy, Needham and Spallanzani. Louis Pasteur, 1822 to 1895, settled the conflict once for all. He tore the neck of flask and drew them out. It is simply defined as fermentation process. According to Louis Pasteur, when heat is given to sugar in the presence of yeast, then it is get converted into ethanol and it releases CO2. Koch postulate. Microorganism must be present in every case of the disease but absent from healthy individuals. The suspected microorganism must be isolated and grown in pure cultures. The disease must result when the isolated microorganism is inoculated into a healthy host. The same microorganism must be isolated from the disease host. Next is Louis Pasteur, 1822 to 1895. Developed vaccine for chickenpox, anthrax and rabies. Demonstrated that all fermentation were due to the activities of specific yeast and bacteria. Also developed pasteurization process, and he is known as the father of microbiology. He also developed the fermentation process in the anaerobic condition, that is in the absence of oxygen. Next is scope of microbiology. Microbiology has an important or impact on medicine, agriculture, food science, ecology, genetics, biochemistry, immunology and many other fields. Many microbiologists are primarily interested in the biology of microorganisms, while other focuses on specific group. See, here it is clearly given that virus and virologist means the one who study on virus, he is known as the virologist. Again, same in case of bacteria, the one who studied on bacteria is known as bacteriologist. Same in case of algae, he is known as phycologist. Again, in case of fungi, he is known as mycologist. And in case of protozoa, is known as protozoologist. Now we will see the scope of microbiology in different fields one by one. Medical microbiology. It deals with diseases of human and animals. Identify and plan measures to eliminate agent causing infectious disease. Immunology. Study of the immune system that protect the body from pathogens. Agriculture microbiology. Impact of microorganism on agriculture, combat plant diseases that attack important food crops. Food and dairy microbiology. Prevent microbial spoilage of food and transmission of foodborne disease, example salmonellosis. Use microorganism to make food such as cheese, yogurt, pickle, beer, etc. Industrial microbiology. Using microorganism to make products such as antibiotics, vaccines, steroid, alcohol and other solvent, vitamins, amino acid, etc. And the last one is genetic engineering. Engineer microorganism used to make hormone, antibiotic, vaccine and other product. So this is about the history and scope of microbiology. Thank you.